Welcome to Floppy Deep Dive, and today I'm going to show you how to add speakers to an Apple IIe. And one of my favorite systems I picked up this year is my Apple IIe, and as you may or may not know, an Apple IIe has an internal speaker built into it, and that's great, but it limits my ability to record the sounds from the system. PCBWay sponsors this video. So why do I have PCBWay support me? Because they do an incredible job. The PCB manufacturing assembly is fantastic. They have an excellent quality assurance for their boards. They also have speed. PCBWay is quick on the turnaround time to give you excellent service and exclusive customer support. And they solve problems quickly. PCBWay also has a great community. I enjoy these cool projects out there that the community shares, so anyone at any skill level can do these projects. PCBWay also listens to feedback from their customers, and that's what I like about PCBWay. If you have not previously watched my channel, I like to do comparison videos of games on different retro computer systems. I do this on my Many Faces series and Commodore versus Atari series, and I want to do a series of Commodore 64 versus the Apple II. And I always prefer to make my comparisons on original hardware and not emulations when possible, and I want to share how it looked and sound back in the 80s. That's why I needed to find a way to record the original sounds of the Apple IIe. And here's the solution that I found that works. Behold the speaker connector for the Apple IIe from Retro Connector. I purchased it from a site, reactivemicro.com. And this adapter is a simple 3.5 millimeter jack connection for external speakers. And you can connect and use the internal speaker at the same time. And you will need to get a speaker cable from your computer to the speakers. I will remove the case so we can access the speaker connector on the motherboard. So now that we have it all open, you can see right here, we have the internal speaker right here connected here to the motherboard, and this is all we're going to be working on today, is replacing this internal speaker with a new adapter. And I'm going to remove the internal speaker, plug in the speaker connector, and then plug the internal speaker back into the connector. Then I'll plug in the speaker cable to run to my speakers. So I got my computer all hooked back up again. So I've got this, the red and white RCA cables plugged directly into this adapter so I could plug directly into. When I first plugged the cable into my speakers, I got a horrible hum. And I needed a way to eliminate it because it would destroy my recordings. I found this device on Amazon from Xiocom. That was a ground loop noise isolator that did a great job stopping the hum. I'll include the link to all the items I'm using today to make it easy for you to purchase. So I connected the Xiocom adapter first into here. And now I'm going to plug it in and it just eliminates the hum. So now I'm just going to load up a game. So you can hear that it's coming through the speakers, working perfectly here. Let's now try and record a video of games from the Apple IIe and see how it works. As you can hear and see, I can now record directly from my Apple IIe. It's not perfect sound. The Apple IIe was never known for its superb sound, but it shows you exactly how I'm experiencing it on my system. I hope this helps anyone looking for a solution to record their Apple IIe gameplay. Watch out for the new Commodore 64 versus the Apple II series comparing the two systems shortly. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, and if you haven't subscribed, please do so. Don't stop there though, click on the following video that YouTube recommends and enjoy some more retro goodness.